Bob Barker saying good night, everybody.
You can win $32,000 on the turn of a card on Card Shark. And if you play your cards right, you can win this beautiful card. And now, the host of Card Shark, Bob Eubanks.
Thank you. Thank you, Gene Wood. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Card Sharks. Glad you could join us today. When we left off last time, we had crowned a new champion. He was about to play the big money for the very first time, so let's get him in here to do it right now. So come on, Mike, right in here.
Hey, pal.
How you doing?
I'm doing fine. I want you to win a lot of money. Tell the folks a little bit about yourself real quickly.
I'm from Boston, Massachusetts originally, and I did 4.5 years in the military, and I love L.A.
Well, great. That's wonderful. And speaking of love, take a look at this. You're going to have a chance to win a lot of money. We've got two very lovely dealers, Lacey and Susanna, are with us each day, and here they are. That's game show transitions. You hear that?
Yeah.
Now, you know how to play the big money cards.
Yes, I do.
In addition to all the money that you can win, we've also added a couple of jokers to the deck. Anytime one of them turns up in the money cards, you'll have a chance at winning this Pontiac 1000. Let me hear you say, a new car.
A new car.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah. Sure. You can do it. And for winning the match, by the way, you automatically get it one chance because Lacey has a joker there for you. That's just for winning the match. So good luck to you. Let's get the man started now with $200. You on your way? Here we go. Mike, first card is a 5.
Higher. Oh.
I know, but how much you want to bet?
150 higher.
150 higher than the 5. There's a 7. Now you got 350. You can call the
change. Change that card.
Which one do you want?
Number one.
Number one. You can change one card per line. Keep that in mind. The 7 becomes a 7 again. Now you got to play with $350.
$50 higher.
$50 higher than the 7. There's a joker.
Ooh.
All right.
That's okay.
We will hand that joker to Lacey. You now have two jokers. Not so bad at all. And this card now becomes a 10.
That's
$50 higher was your bet.
Okay.
You got.
I'm going to go. $200 lower.
$200 yes. Lower than the 10. Let's see if it is. Yes, it
Ooh.
Is. Now, 550. Come up here. You got 400. And by the way, because you made a mistake in your total before, you have another $100. So now you have $1,050 and the deuce.
All of it higher.
All of it higher than the deuce. Yeah.
Woo!
I like what you got.
Ooh.
Another 100.
$2,000 lower.
$2,000 lower than the king, you bet. $4,100.
$2,000 higher.
Well, I'm going to keep the 5 and go $2,000 higher than the 5. Come on, Mike. Be there. It is. $6,100. The queen is your card. You've got to bet at least half of it. So that means $3,050.
Lower.
How much?
Half of it.
Gonna bet half of it.
$3,050 lower.
$3,050 lower than the queen. Come on. It is!
$9,150.
Mike, $9,150.
Yeah.
Brings your total to $9,350. Lacey's got two jokers for you. You're gonna have two chances to win the new car. And we'll be back in just a moment to see if he does it.
Thank you.
Buzzr has all your favorite game show sets. Then, we just add stars.
Dynamite.
Oh, boy!
It's Watson Bacon. Hand him the money.
And our newest game show set.
Welcome to the newlywed game.
Oh, I mean, that's rich.
Buzzr, let's play. For more fun and games, visit BuzzrTV.com.
Welcome back to Card Sharks. Our champ, first time out, $9,350 playing for the big money, my friend. And Lacey has two jokers for you, one for winning the match, one that popped up over there during the big money cards. That means you're going to have two chances to win this beautiful car, and take a look at it.
A new Pontiac 1000 three-door hatchback, a sporty, spirited, and proven performer from Pontiac. With 1.6-liter engine and California emission. Okay, Bob.
All right. Pretty nice car, Mike.
Yes.
Two chances to win it. Let me tell you now. There are seven numbered cards over there. Behind one of them is the word car. You place the jokers anywhere you want to place them, and good luck to you. Where are you going to put them? Turn them around so we can see them. Will you do that for me?
Sure.
There you go. All right. He says behind number seven and behind number one. At either end of the spectrum. Good luck to you. Here we go. All right. Now, this is where the excitement begins, because behind one of these is the word car. Is this the one? I hope it is. Mike, behind here is... No. That means
okay.
Got another chance. All right. Still, remain nervous if you would.
Yes.
All right. This is the word car behind this one. It is not. No. Where was it? Oh, all right. There. Had you chosen number five? It was right there. It's okay. You're the champ. If you win the next match, you'll have a chance to do it all over again. So if you're ready to play Card Sharks, go right over there. And come on, Monique, let's play the game.
Hi, how are you doing?
How are you, pretty lady?
Fine, Bob. My name is Monique Thompson. I'm in the Air Force, and I'm a newlywed. I've been married 6 months, 11 days, and 3 hours.
Yay! All right. How's the marriage going?
Oh, it's great. It's great, Bob.
What does he do?
Oh, he's in the Air Force also.
Who outranks who?
He does. He's a sergeant.
Well, he's supposed to outrank you, isn't he?
Of course he is.
Well, yes.
Of course he is.
Sure. Who's the boss at your house?
He is. Always.
Yeah, I bet.
Yeah.
Okay, you know how to play this game, don't
sure
you?
Play
All right, right. We're going to play set the cards up. Lacey, deal out the cards from decks that you cut before we went on the air. You win two games. You're the champ. You go on to play for the big money. I want to wish you both the very best of luck. Mike here, he won a lot of money just a minute ago. First question. Mike, this is yours.
Okay.
We surveyed 100 top business executives, and we asked them, have you ever had a romance with someone in your office? How many top business executives admitted that they have?
Admitted that is the word.
Yeah.
I'm not an executive, but I know that probably there's a lot of it going on. But the word, like I said, admitted is in there. So I'm going to say about 25.
25 out of 100 top business executives admitted that they have. Yes, Monique.
Bob, I think that's going to be a lot higher. A lot higher, because I know that, you know, there are a lot of times that the husbands say that they're coming home and, you know, they're working late, and I know that they're probably having an affair.
You had a romance with someone in your office, didn't you?
No, I didn't.
You married him.
Yes.
That's right. Sure. Okay. The actual number of top executives who had a romance with someone in their office is 27. You're right, Monique. It was higher. All right, Monique. Here we go. First card is a 3.
Higher.
Yeah, I knew you'd say it. Higher.
Lower.
Yeah. Lower than the 8. Look here.
Freeze
on the 6?
Yes,
she's going to play a real conservative, isn't she? She froze right there on that 6. And we'll go to another question. This is yours, Monique. And all this week, we've had 10 very nice married women in our studio audience with us, and they're all there ready to play the game. Welcome back, ladies. Now, Monique, before the show, we asked these 10 married women, if your husband handed you a legal document and asked you to sign it without reading it, would you do it? How many of these 10 women would sign a legal document without reading it?
I think these women look smart, Baba. I think that they won't let their husbands just give them a piece of paper and they don't know what it is. It could be a divorce decree. So I say about 3, Bob. 3 of those women.
So if your husband walked in and said, sign this, Monique, you wouldn't sign it?
No, I wouldn't sign it, Bob.
Oh, isn't love wonderful? Mike, higher or lower than that?
I wouldn't sign a document if my wife gave me one, and I'm not married. So I'm going to say it's even lower than that.
Even lower than that.
Yes.
Actual number of these women who would sign a legal document without reading it is 3 of them. Whoa! Well. There's $100 for you, and our audience participants will also share $100. There's three very trusting ladies down there. Now, which three are you? Right? Well, there's two. Now, somebody else fess up now. Who else said that they would sign a document if their husband... Oh, Mickey, did I wake you?
Yeah.
I am so sorry. You were thinking about it again. Has your husband ever done that to you, Mickey?
Yes.
He has to say, sign this, Mickey, and you didn't read it?
I always do.
Are you glad?
It's never bothered me. I'm used to it.
Oh, okay.
He takes good care of me. I trust him.
Yeah, but you're the one that has to get up and get the burglars, right?
Yes.
Yeah, I understand it. All right, ladies, thank you very much. Okay, Monique, you froze on the six.
Change
the card, Bob? Yeah. Six becomes a deuce.
Higher,
how's that?
Higher
than the deuce. Your card's now a seven.
Ooh.
What will the lady do?
Change.
Can't change it. No, you can't change it.
Freeze.
Okay. Freeze. Okay. Yes. You're nervous. It's okay, Monique. You're doing wonderful. You're doing wonderful. All right. Next question. Now, this is yours, Mike. And this is one of our educated guess questions. Ooh. Here's the question. How many years ago was the first human heart transplant performed? How many years ago was that?
That was just recently. The first human... No, that was artificial. Human heart transplant's been around for a while. I would say about 15 years ago.
15 years? Monique, you think it's higher or lower than that?
I think that's a little higher, Bob. Yes.
You think it's going to be higher than that?
Higher.
Seems like it just yesterday. Was it Dr. Christian Bernard did that? I think so, yeah. The actual number of years ago that the first heart transplant was performed is 18. Yes. It's a good guess, though, Mike. Real good guess. You were just real close. But, Monique, you have the control of the cards again, my dear.
I want to change that card. Please.
Yeah, now you can change it, huh? Sure. The seven is now a 10.
Lower.
If it's lower, you win game number one. Is it lower? Yeah. Well, now you got $200.
Yes.
Isn't this fun?
Yes.
Yeah, I think you'd like it. That also means you've won the first game. If you win the next game, you're our champ. Mike's going to try to keep that from happening. We'll pause with a couple of words. We'll be right back with more Card Sharks right after this. See you in a minute. Welcome back to Card Sharks. Our challenger won game number one. And we're ready to start game number two. Lacey's has dealt out the cards from the same deck, and we're on our way. So, Mike, you got to win this game in order to stay in this match.
Okay.
And let's go. First question for Monique. It involves our 10 lovely married ladies who are in our studio audience, and here's our question now. Ladies. Monique, before the show, we ask our 10 married women, have you ever fibbed to your husband about how much money you spent on a dress? How many of these 10 women admitted, yeah, they fibbed about how much money they spent on a dress?
Well, Bob, I fibbed to my husband before about, you know, how much I spent on a dress. So I'd say about, these women look real dressy, so I'm sure they fibbed. I'd say about five.
Five of them have fibbed, you think? Mike, what do you think?
They are well-dressed, and I don't think they would consider it a fib. Maybe it's
a slight
lie.
Mean, yeah.
I'm going to say it's a little bit higher.
You think it's even higher than that?
Yes. Yes.
Actual number of these women who have fibbed about how much money they spent on a dress is six of them. You're right, it was higher.
Thank you.
Ladies, I'm sorry you have to fib about this, but which six ladies fibbed about how much they spent on a dress? You didn't. Terry, how much did the dress cost?
Oh, $40.
$40. How much did you tell him it cost?
Oh, $20.
He must think you shop at Goodwill at $20. All right, ladies, thank you very much. Appreciate it. All right. Mike, here's the card now. The card's a queen.
Ooh, good. Lower.
Lower. Is it lower? Yep, it is.
Lower.
Lower again. Yes, again.
Freeze.
Freezer. All right. We will freeze. The man from Boston has chosen to freeze right there. You know about that freezing,
yes,
don't you? Okay, Mike, this is your question. We surveyed 100 marriage counselors. We asked them, generally speaking, if a man decides to get married for the first time at the age of 40, is he a bad risk? How many marriage counselors said, yes, a man who marries for the first time at the age of 40 is a bad risk?
I think that's going to be a low number because my dad was 29 when he got married, and I think the older you are, the more mature and, you know, together you are and financially
stable. Well, that's true, Mike.
So it's going to be a low number. I'd say about... 20
of them. All right. 20 marriage counselors said, yes, a man who marries for the first time at the age of 40 is a bad risk. Monique, higher or lower than that?
Okay, Bob, I think that's going to be just a little bit higher. Because,
think it'll be higher?
Yeah, I think it's going to be a little higher.
Men are kind of set in their ways at the age of 40, aren't they? All right. Actual number of marriage counselors who said a man who marries for the first time at the age of 40 is a bad risk is 29 of them. You're right, Monique. It was just a little bit higher. Okay, Monique, you have some catching up to do. You ready to do it?
Yes, ready.
Your card is a 3.
Higher.
Higher than the 3.
Lord.
Look at that. Oh, look at here.
Freeze.
Okay, so we're all tied up. Both contestants have 2 cards to turn over, 1 to win the match, 1 to tie it up. And we'll go right to another question, Monique, again, with our 10 ladies in our studio audience. And here is the question. Before the show, Monique, we asked these 10 married women, have you ever put your husband on a diet without him knowing it? How many of these 10 women have put their husband on a diet without him knowing it?
Oh, well, Bob, I do that a lot. I'm on a diet, so I make my husband go on a diet. He doesn't know it, but, you know, I eat a small salad and I fix him a little salad. So I think that these women, I think it'll be about 6.
6 of them. Mike.
Lower. Lower than that. I know what I eat when it's on my plate.
Yeah, I don't know how anybody could put me on a diet without me knowing it, but we'll see. The actual number of these women who have put their husband on a diet without him knowing it is 2 of them. Yeah.
Change that time.
I said 2 of them, and Mickey just raised her hand. Boy, you didn't fall asleep this time, did you, Mick?
I didn't wait.
What kind of diet did you put him on, Mickey?
We just skip a meal.
That's a good diet. You just didn't want to cook, that's all. Who does the cooking in your house?
I do.
Who wears the pants in your house?
He does.
Who's the boss in your house?
I am.
That's what I figured, yes. Doesn't matter who wears the pants, who's the boss does it. Okay, thank you, ladies. All right, Mike, what do you want to do?
Change that card.
We will. 8 is the jack.
Okay, lower.
Lower than the jack. Look here, 5.
Higher.
Okay, if it's higher than the 5, that means you win the second game. We'll tie it up and play a tiebreaker game. Higher than the 5, yes. Woo! And that ties the whole thing up. So, 1 game for Monique and 1 game for Mike. Tiebreaker game coming up. That'll determine who our champion is and who plays for the big money. First, we must pause, though, for these words, and we'll be right back with more Card Sharks in just a second. Welcome back to Card Sharks. Tiebreaker time. Winner of this game becomes our champion, plays for the big money. If you notice this time that Lacey will deal out only 3 cards, we'll have a maximum of 3 high-low questions. And good luck to you. So, the winner of this game is the one. You ready? Mike, question for you. Surveyed 116-year-old girls, and we ask them, would you rather have dinner with Sean Penn and Madonna than with President and Mrs. Reagan? How many 16-year-old girls said yes, they would rather have dinner with Sean Penn and Madonna?
I'd like to have dinner with Sean Penn and Madonna.
He just slaps everybody around. I don't want
to. Anyways, I think 16-year-old girls, they buy all these teen magazines, they were idols, Sean Penn and Madonna. I'm going to say about 67.
67 out of 100. Monique, higher or lower than that?
That's going to be a lot higher. I know I'd love to be with Sean Penn and Madonna.
A lot
right
higher
now,
than
so
that?
It's going to be higher.
The actual number of 16-year-old girls who would rather have dinner with Sean Penn and Madonna is 74. You're right, Monique. It was higher. Okay, Monique, you're 3 cards away from winning this championship. Here we go. This is the 10. You can change if you want to.
Change it, please.
Change it? All right. 10 becomes an ace.
Lower,
how's that?
Lower.
Lower than the ace. Your card's a 5.
Higher.
If it's higher, you are the new champ. Is it higher than the 5? Yes, it is! You're the champ!
Thank you,
congratulations to you. Well, Mike, you end up with $9,450. Thank you very much, and we'll see you again. Bye-bye, pal. Come here, Monique. It's going to be so much fun, isn't it? Now you have a chance to win thousands of dollars. You also have a chance to win a new car. This is going to be one of the most exciting times of your life. So hang on, kid, because here comes Susanna and Lacey right now. They've got a deck of cards that you cut before we went on the air. We're ready to play for the big money. Now, you know the money you won so far is yours to keep, and you know how to play our big money. In addition to the money you can win, we've also added a couple of jokers to the deck. Anytime one of them turns up in the money cards, you'll have a chance at winning this Pontiac 1000, which is a real nice car. And boy, would we like to see you win that. And just for winning the match, we have 1 extra joker for you. That'll guarantee you at least 1 chance of winning that car, okay? Good luck. Let's win a lot of money. Give her $200. We're on our way. Here we go. Come on, Monique. Boy, are we rooting for you, kid. First card is an 8, and you can change it if you want to.
I'm going to change it with the 2?
Sure.
Number two
card. All right. Change one card per line. Remember that. The eight becomes a jack, and you got $200.
150 lower.
150. Lower than the jack, you've now got $350.
150 higher.
150 higher than the six, and it is. Now you got 500.
300 higher. Yes, I want to go
300 higher, right?
Yes, higher.
Okay. 300 higher than the eight. It is. 800. Come up here and give you another 400. You got $1,200 in the jack.
800 lower.
800 lower. Whew, that's making me real nervous. 800 lower than the jack. Come on, be there. No. $400.
All of it lower.
All of it lower. You come to win money, haven't you? Okay, all of it lower than the queen. It is lower than the queen.
Can I change that with number one?
Sure, you can change it. Number one. All right, let's see what the nine is now. The nine is now a four, and you've got $800.
700 higher.
$700 higher than the four. Yes! 1,500, and now what are you going to do, kid?
All of it lower.
Yeah, you know what this means? This means $3,000 to you. There you go.
Thank you.
That's the way to do it. You had some tough cards. You made some gutsy bets, though, I'll tell you that.
I shouldn't have did that on this thing.
No, you did just fine. You've got $3,300. Lacey's got a joker there. You're going to give one chance to win that car. We'll pause with these words and be right back and give her that chance right after this. Welcome back to Card Sharks. Our champ has got $3,300, one joker. Susanna's got seven cards over there behind them. One of the cards is the word car. Find it for me, and you win that car. She says it's behind number seven. Boy, I hope it is. Come on, Monique. Let's win us a car, all right? If it's behind here, you win the car, my dear. Wouldn't that be something? Let's see what's behind here. The car! Bye-bye, everybody.
Greenwood speaking for Card Sharks, a Mark Goodson television production.
Time.